It wasn't so long ago that when teachers asked children what they want to be, they meant what profession. Now they're asking them which animal, object or beast they may identify as and tailoring their lessons accordingly. This isn't satire, it's a genuine story. It's true. It's going on in schools up and down the country. And for those of us who have warned for years about the inevitable consequence of limitless self-identity, it sadly won't come as a surprise. But it is shocking. This story begins with a video that circulated yesterday of a teacher in England scolding two pupils for refusing to accept that one of their classmates identified as a cat.
You're questioning their identity.
I wasn't a question. I was just saying about the gender. I didn't say anything about them.
But where did you get this idea from? There's only two genders. Gender is not linked to do with the not linked there to the class that you were born with. Gender is about how you identify. There is actually three large percent. Because you can be born intersex. You can be born with male and female body parts or hormones. In terms of gender, there are lots of genders.
If you have a vagina, you're a girl. If you have a penis, you're a boy.
Yeah.
But you identify with the gender that of the sexual organ that you're born with, yeah. Or you're weird. That's basically what you're saying.
Yeah.
Which is really despicable.
Despicable. So at the age of 13, those students who were wise enough to express an honestly held opinion, which is one most people in the world would share, well, for that, their own teacher says they're despicable. And if they hold that view, they should go to a different school. That view being that girls have vaginas and boys have penises. That's so despicable, they would have to leave the school. I think what's despicable in that exchange is what that teacher said. The Daily Telegraph today followed up were interviewing pupils at schools across the United Kingdom for a major investigation. It read like a farce, like they made it up. But it was actually true. They came up with all sorts of examples from all over the country that looked like we were living on, frankly, a different planet to the one that most of us think we're living on. Which makes sense, because some of the kids they write about are identifying as alien life forms literally on a different planet. They say that children in high schools are being allowed to self-identify as cats, horses, dinosaurs, even a moon. Not the moon, a moon. And they're deadly serious about this. Often this causes disruption in lessons, the Telegraph reported, because in some cases they'll only communicate in animal noises. Pupils at schools where children identify as cats complained to the newspaper that classes are dominated by the children because they insist on meowing. This is not a joke. This is serious. One pupil at a state secondary school in Wales said a fellow pupil feels very discriminated against if you do not refer to them as cat self. Telegraph discovered that a pupil at one high school is insisting on being addressed as a dinosaur, another as a horse. One wears a cape and wants to be acknowledged, like I said, as a moon. The children are allowed to wear items like cat's ears, while other human-identifying children are rebuked for untucked shirts. Well, enough is enough. Put it this way. What would you feel if I said I'm a cat? Seriously. I do actually feel quite feline. I took in two kittens in January, my first pets I've had since I was a teenager. Two little Burmese kittens called Dennis and Bobby for Arsenal fans, named after Bergkamp and Pires. And I frankly now feel like one of them. I feel like I identify as a cat. I snack a lot, I enjoy regular naps, I have higher than average intelligence. I'm curious and inquisitive. I have a natural born predatory instinct when it comes to attacking rivals who attack me. And everywhere I go, people want to stroke my chin and call me cute. So yes, I'm a cat. But there's one problem. I'm a human, really. I'm not actually a cat. Scientifically and biologically, I'm a human being. Incontrovertibly, it's a fact. Much as I'd like to enjoy the benefits of being a cat, 20 hours naps, no taxes, meals on demand when I cry, I can't because I'm not a cat. Now, if all of this is shocking to you, it's probably because you haven't been paying attention. Most of these teachers are probably trying to do the right thing, terrified of being reported for bigotry for failing to indulge the gender whims of children. And the children themselves have grown up in a world where they're literally taught there are hundreds of genders and anybody can identify as anything they want. But they can't. And when something like this happens, society changes so radically and so fast and becomes so ridiculous that it causes complete chaos. And we surely should be questioning this. It cannot simply be the case that minority groups are right. End of question. And anyone who raises questions about it is automatically a bigot or a transphobe. I'm not bigoted or transphobic. But I do think this is insanity. And the next time a child identifies as a cat at school in this country, they should be told that as a mark of deep respect for their new identity, they will be taken out of the classroom, put in a cage with other actual cats who will scratch and bite them all day. They'll be given water and Whiskers tuna chunks for lunch, taken for walks on leads at break time, and must use a litter tray for a toilet, one that won't be changed for several days. Trust me, they'll soon be re-identifying as humans by tea time.